How's it going, guys? It's Mouseball, and this is the Attack Mouse Nation, and I'm here with Oleski and my nephews, the SSP at Cars and Coffee. Obviously, it's raining, and it's crappy weather, but you know what? Car enthusiasts show up no matter what, and right here, this is their whole lineup. Got this beautiful purple BMW with probably the best wheels of the whole group. I mean, these Diablo wheels look amazing on this car. My nephew's Fiesta ST with the Focus RS bumper. One of the first here in Florida to have that. His friend's Mustang. This GTI looks awesome. I love the purple on this car. And the silver GTI looks really mean as well. Then you got Elvis's.
Hey, what's up, bro? What's up?
Got Mike. Hey, how's it going, guys?
How's the Corvette?
The Corvette is, got to get the transmission programmed. And then I got to work on getting the first seat all torn down.
Hi, people.
Yeah, we're doing this lineup for YouTube.
Oh, no. Okay, I said hi, bye. The broke boys? The money spenders?
It's more about tires. And with the inflation, man, you're definitely broke.
Non-functional lineup.
I don't know if it's non-functional, but it functions in breaking people's necks. So as far as I'm concerned, that works out pretty good. But right here we got Elvis's Subaru. Super nice Subaru. And this Honda, it's a different vintage. Definitely looks super nice with the camber on it. But all these cars are stanced out. They don't really, like he says, they don't really function as far as like a drivable car, which is fine. You know, I mean, everybody has their own style, but you can't take it away from them that they definitely do break necks. These cars have a style all their own. And they're not for everybody, but that's what car culture is all about. I mean, this Volkswagen Passat, front end off of it, probably from sending it. And when you're stanced, you're gonna have a little bit of damage, like my nephew's fender right here, which we just painted and I'm gonna end up painting again. You know, it is what it is. That's how it goes when you're into this kind of, build. So regardless, it's a great lineup for my nephew. His friend's got really nice cars, as always. And you know what? These are builds that are works in progress. They always are getting better and better as they go on. Now we're gonna go back over and go see Mouseball. Now, before we go see Mouseball, I want you guys to check out this one. It's really neat. This one's the Evil Egg. This is a Nissan N200. And even though the front end is got the paint coming off of it, these are the European front ends, the classic ones that were almost like that Nerf foam. And basically they, you know, look like that from the factory. That's how they came. And as you can see, there's the Ford Focus RS. And there's how the bumper looks on the actual Ford Focus as opposed to my nephew's Fiesta ST. Now this one's nice. This Focus is a ST, which basically I thought it was a base model at first, but actually it's an ST. It fooled me for a little bit there because it didn't look as aggressive as I thought it was going to look. But this Infiniti, I mean, this is one of the fastest Infinities in West Palm Beach, bar none, dead nuts. It's really quick. I mean, this car has been known to beat just about anything on the road. It's pretty amazing. This one right here, this Scion FRS, basically at this point, it's a classic. This particular car has the Despicable Me minions in it. I love that. I love when people theme out their cars because it gives them personality. You know, obviously I'm biased because I've done that to my car, actually to both my cars. But right here, the Shelby GT500. This vintage is super nice. Always like this one. And this car, wow. Coyote swap. Just needs a SVT Cobra front bumper and it'll probably be complete. But then again, like I said, all these cars are constant works in progress. There's my friend Santos Mustang, and we have a purple C8 Corvette. And obviously C8 Corvettes are always nice to see. Just, this car has amazing, it has beautiful lines. I mean, just fantastic car. You know, a long time coming. So now we'll finally go over to Mouse Ball and show you how Mouse Ball's been doing. And obviously with the rain, you know, you're dealing with the rain getting into the hood. So I have the magnet currently on the car, but the rain's subsiding a little bit. It's starting to just drizzle. At one point, it was so bad we actually had to sit inside the cars. But the show is actually more active than it was in November. In November, there really wasn't a whole lot going on. But then again, it is a Christmas holiday, so. But it looks like the hood's cooled down a bit, but so far so good. Mouse Ball's, you know, hanging in there despite getting all wet. And again, like my nephew, you know, we spent a lot of time detailing and cleaning these cars just for them to get wet and get dirty all over again, you know, which sucks, but hey, what can you do? But guys, stay happy, stay healthy, stay wealthy. And remember, when you say rain, rain, go away, you might have to cover up Mouse Ball. Take it easy, guys. Mouse Ball out.